Shopping online is about to become more expensive as some lawmakers have their way, and Emily Price shows us why. Emily?
Kevin, most of the online shopping that we all do right now does not require you to pay a state sales tax. Lawmakers say that isn't fair to businesses who sell things out of buildings, so they're working to make it a more even playing field.
Okay, I'm submitting my order. No shipping, no tax.
With a click of a button, Claire Selsey just snapped up the black strappy sandals she's been eyeing. She bought them at Zappos.com, a web-based retailer that doesn't have to charge sales tax.
Last year, I ordered all my Christmas gifts online. I bought new table linens and napkins and even some dishes online, so I'm sure I saved into the hundreds of dollars.
Selsey does half of all her shopping online.
I don't have time for all that shopping. I just really don't. So yeah. It just saves me a lot of time.
More and more people are like her.
Online is about 10 to 12% of our business.
G&L Clothing has been rooted in Des Moines for 95 years, but the fastest growing part of their business is not in their Ingersoll store. It's online.
If you're in Illinois and you happen to be passing through town, if you stop in the store, you'll pay sales tax at the counter. If you go home to Illinois and order it online, you won't right now.
Owner Frank Markovas has been closely watching what's happening with this bill, which would affect businesses that have $1 million or more in online sales each year. He says G&L Clothing is right on the cusp of that figure.
Is the law going to be cumbersome, you know, for us to try and figure out how each borough in New York City charges tax and have to charge that tax and then remit that tax could be quite burdensome. But if it's simplified, if it's the same rate all across the country, that can be done fairly simply. I don't think it would be that difficult as long as they don't complicate the law, which is maybe an oxymoron.
eBay's CEO emailed millions of its users urging them to contact Congress to fight this.
What's the status of the bill in Congress right now, Emily?
It passed the Senate yesterday. Its future is uncertain in the House, though, because Republicans in the majority consider it a tax hike. Meantime, President Barack Obama supports it, so we're just going to have to wait and see what happens from here.
All right, we will. Thanks, Emily.